Hello again, this is Kent, and we are in Inkscape Tutorials for Beginners, Moving, Scaling, Rotating, the video number 7. And I did talk a little about these abilities in Inkscape in previous videos, but I'll do the same again. Now, I'm using my selector tool. You can either hit spacebar or, I usually hit spacebar, but you can also use hit your function 1 key. And then if you select your shape or object or whatever you're selecting, you can even select, you know, your path or a path, or you'll see these arrows. And again, as I've talked about in the previous videos, watch these notes if you ever wonder what something does. So when I hover over this, it shows scale, selection, and you can and then it actually talks you or tells you that you can actually hit your control key down or even your shift key down. And you can actually hit them both at the same time, too. So if I, you know, I can scale it freely. If I hit control, it keeps the same aspect ratio. If I hit control and shift, it scales about the center point, and it also keeps the same aspect ratio. If I hold the shift down, and then shift key down, and then it just it scales about the center point. Okay. Now I forgot to talk about moving it. Basically, you just grab it with your left button on your mouse, and click on top of it, and then hold your mouse down, and then move your mouse around on your mouse pad or whatever, and you can so it's basically the same. I'm adding this after I complete the video. One thing I forgot was that you can actually move this, your object, when moving. You can, you know, move it with your cursor, but you can also move it with your arrow buttons on your keyboard. Sometimes that's helpful, especially if you can't, you're not sure if you're grabbing something correctly, and then you can move the arrows instead of your mouse. I mean, if you actually select something and you're not sure if you select the right item, you can move your arrow buttons. You can also hit shift arrow, and it moves it like, I think, 10 increments. Like if it's pixels, you're working in pixels, it'd be 10 pixels. Anyway, that might help. And then rotating it, you have it select. Once you have it selected, you click it again, and then these rounded arrows on the corners allow you to rotate it. And you can also hit your control key down on your keyboard, and then rotate it in 15-degree increments. Look at the notes at the bottom. And right now we're at 90 degrees and 75, 60, etc. This middle one is for skewing, and you can also hold your control key down on your keyboard and skew it in 15-degree increments. Another interesting option is to move this focal point, or the point at which the item is manipulated, even rotated. So if I put it over here in this, remember it was rotating about the center. If I put this focal point or the center over here in this upper left-hand corner, and then I go to rotate it, it rotates around that point. So, you know, if you're drawing a person with an arm or something like that, and you wanted to rotate, and let's say this is the shoulder. Well, that's not really there. If I let's say this is the shoulder, and I want to rotate about the shoulder point, can rotate it like that. Or if you want to select both of them. The one that was selected first is where it's going to be rotated around. Now you have to change your, let's see, let's have it like an elbow, be like that, and then if you let go and then select that one first, then it will rotate about the elbow because I select that one first. But you have to move the focal point first. I also want to show you that there is a window that allows you to do all these various functions, which helps you to be a little more exact. It's Shift-Control-M, transform. So it opens up this window and allows you to move an item. And the relative movement is with respect to itself. So its relative move is selected. If I want to move it 50 pixels to the right, I just go 50 and then apply. Or I can go negative, let's say go negative 50 vertically, so they'd be going down, apply. Oh, actually, since I still had the 50 in the horizontal, it went negative 50, or it went positive 50 horizontally, and then negative 50, so it went basically lower. It lowered and then went to the right. Well, if you go relatively, it will be exact to the drawing space. So I have, if I hit 0, 0, it'll go to the lower corner here, like that. And then you have the other, you have the scale function, the rotate, skew. I don't use a matrix, so I don't, and I don't, you know, I guess I really don't know exactly how to use that yet, so I don't use it. You can hit, for scaling, you can scale proportionally by selecting that, and then rotate it in specific degrees. Another, a good reference for some of these functions, let me see, would be this this website, or this this is a Inkscape manual, and this is actually on the page where what we're talking about is moving, scaling, and rotating. It just goes into really good detail. And it has a table of contents. If you just look at this URL, and you can copy that. It has a table of contents, has an index. It's really a good reference. Okay, so if you like this video, and please like it, and if you want to subscribe, please do that too to see other videos that I'll be making. Thanks.